ಚೆನ್ನಾರ ಪೊಂಗವ ಗಿವ್ ಮಿ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವೈಶ್ ತುಳಸಿದಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಇನ್ ದ ಫೇಮಸ್ ವಿವೇಕ ಚೂಡಾಮಣಿ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಾಧನೆ ಚತುಷ್ಟಯ ಹಿ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಭಕ್ತಿ. ಭಕ್ತಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಈಸಿಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ವೇ ಟು ಅಟೈನ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ವಾಂಟ್. ಸ್ವಾತ್ಮತತ್ವಾನುಸಂಧಾನ ಭಕ್ತಿ ರೀತಿಯ ಪರೇಜಬಹು. ಹಿಯರ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಟೇಕನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಡ್ಯುಯಲಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಡಿವೋಷನ್ ಟು ಎ ಗಾಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಟೂ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ ದೇ ಕಂಬೈನ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಹೋಮೋಜಿನಿಯಸ್. ತುಳಸಿರಾಜ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ indication to that, that inside the heart my desire is that I seek you Rama, but I am not able to really go for it. Why? Kamadi dosha rahitam kuru manasam cha. Though my heart wants this, that is the conflict inside our personality between the heart and the mind. One is a rational and another is the emotional. Whenever there is a conflict between the heart and the intellect, Swamiji says always follow the heart. But it is not easy to follow the heart, because we are where our heart is. But when the heart starts functioning, the mind comes in between. With all the past impressions, it will make us go against our own wish. Though we want to go to Rama, mind says, fellow, hundreds of kamas, desires, you only thought about these desires, you had so many aspirations, ambitions, and mind will come out with a list of desires. First fulfill this, you decide now. Did you not want these desires? Yes. Then suddenly why you are turning there? No, my heart wants. Your heart wanted these things in the beginning. Now they all got lodged in the unconscious, subconscious realm of our mind. So when the heart wants to go towards God, a sadhaka, the aspirant, finds that it is difficult for him to plunge forward. Moment he wants to go forward, the habitual tendency of the mind pulls him down. And then there is a conflict, a struggle ensues inside his mind. That struggle is quite shattering, because the mind wants, no, heart wants and the mind doesn't want. How to make the mind and heart unified? That is where bhakti comes. Bhakti is a unified flow of the whole personality. The heart and the mind becomes one, and therefore the conflict ceases. Heart is the wife, mind is the husband. Wife wants to come to Ramakrishna Mutt, husband says, what about the preparations? You have to send the children to the school, I have to take the tiffin to the office, you are running behind the ashrama. When bhakti comes, and if we are fortunate, the husband and the wife, both of them, they turn out to be devotees of Sri Ramakrishna. And when the wife wants to come to the ashram, husband says, okay, pray for me also. I will come in the evening. So the combination of the heart and the mind is one of the important things in our spiritual life. We hardly understand this. And even after deciding God in the heart, emotional aspect is so strengthened, but unable to proceed forward. Sri Ramakrishna, the genius as he was, he gives a very beautiful picture of this state of mind. He says, during our younger days in the Kamarpukur villages, we used to find mongoose roaming here and there. And these naughty, mischievous children sometimes will catch hold of the mongoose, tie a 3 feet rope onto the tail of the mongoose, and at the other end they will tie a brick. Not knowing this, the mongoose will climb the wall. Up to 3 feet it will go. Pulled down by the weight of the brick, again it will come back. again it will go and again it will come back. Are we not doing the same thing? We go and then again we come back. Again we go, we come back, always on the square number one. Because in spite of the craving of the heart to be united with the God, even for us also, last 4-5 years I am telling, I don't meditate on Kashi Vishwanath, I meditate on Cash Vishwanath. Because so much of workload is that we want to finish it, and therefore every time we want to put the mind, even during the preparation for these talks, I used to feel half the mind is there in the building of the ashrama. Once that is over, kamadi dosha rahitam rama, all these kamas, the desires are the agenda which we have kept in the mind, which we want to fulfill. It is lying hidden in the mind, janma janma antare. Hundreds of births we had so many desires, because the personality of man is a combination of the heart and the head, heart and the mind. So the whole thing must be combined, and bhakti is where there is no contradiction. Heart gets the prema, mind has accumulated the kama, the desires. So bhakti is, Narada says, sattu asmin parama prema swarupa. We have now adhama prema. What is the adhama prema? Attachment to the worldly things. They are also prema. I like my child, I like my husband, wife, so many things. We have got adhama prema. That is the mind running towards the objects of the senses. Though it may look very insignificant, the potency of this tendency of the mind to run behind the things of the world, you will find, acts when we want to meditate or do japa. Exactly at that time, all these thoughts will come, will not allow a sadhaka to proceed forward. How many years we are meditating, is it not? After long years of struggle also, devotees will ask how to concentrate. Yes, it's not an easy thing entering the ocean, because mind is a huge sagara. Mind is a real samsara sagara. To cross the mind, Ranti ki pahadi, nadiya beachmo, ahankari ki bhayavat. How to cross this valley, rivers, mountains and the tornado of ego blowing constantly, it is all inside the mind. Swamiji also gives a very beautiful picture of the mind in the Amba Stotram or maybe Shiva Stotram. Vahati vipula vataha purva samskara rupaha pramadati balavrindam ghurnite rormimala prachalati kali yugmam yushmat asmat prati natanayana niyuktam neelakantam namamaha. This impressions, accumulated impressions of the old births, all the acts we have done, the thoughts, the words, the deeds, everything are lying hidden, and that is what is coming up when we start to act. The impulse is coming from the heart, but that impulse of the heart must be complemented by refined, purified mind. Mind when purified, when kamas are not there, then it becomes prema. Adhama prema is nothing but kama, desires for things of the world. However we may boast, we are behind Sri Ramakrishna, it's not so easy. Once in the West, Swamiji was attending a lecture by a Christian father, and the father told, give all you have unto Jesus and follow me. And after the talk, collection was made, and whatever collection Swamiji had in the pocket, He had given lecture in the morning. The entire collection Swamiji emptied out in the basket which the person brought. And the lady who arranged the lecture for Swamiji said, "Oh Swami, you emptied the whole thing. Whatever collection we made in the morning for your lectures, you wanted for India, huge collection." No, but the man told, "No, given to me all that you have and follow Jesus. So whatever I had, I have given. But giving unto the Lord whatever we have, it is not so easy. Giving up, so that giving up is emptying oneself, which is a difficult task. We are very fondly holding on to things of our own memories. Memories, though they are like ashes, which cannot cook a food like fire, the memories are so fond, is it not? Again and again, like the cow chewing the cud, we live only on memories most of the time, is it not? The past seems to be so predominant, we refuse to come out of the past, and God is an eternal present. God cannot be caught by the past, and He doesn't have a future, because He is Kalatita. And we are Kalabadha. Mostly the past extending. Every time you watch yourself, you will find it is the memories that is acting. Even our Japa meditation, it has become a memory. Memory means it has got no real fire. It is always the past. When you do an action, at the time of that action, it remains very fresh in the present. After some time, the action, either in the form of a thought or a word or a deed, goes back and gets lodged in the subconscious mind. And that is what is guiding the next actions, is it not? You can easily watch it. You can test it. Last 2 years before I tested, whether really mind picks up the things which we do at night and whether it is the same thing we repeat in the morning. Night 10:45, I switched on and watched Enter the Dragon film. I don't know whether you have seen it, it's by Bruce Lee. It's a lovely film, adventurous film without any masala. Long before in the college I had seen it. Just out of curiosity I switched on. And by 12:30 I went to bed. Early morning, 5 o'clock, when I sat for meditation, I found it is not Sri Ramakrishna but Bruce Lee who is coming into the meditation. Without my effort, what went inside, with that I came out. So most of the time, what do we go with at the time of night? The whole day's collection of thoughts, is it not? The collection of the thoughts with which we go inside indicates that we are clinging to the happenings of the 24 hours. Otherwise, it will not cling to us. So memory becomes more and more strengthened. Two important things come here. One is, who is a good teacher? A good teacher is one who leaves the board clean after her class is over, is it not? Many times teachers, they leave the class for the next teacher, but the board is full of her teachings. Either she is solving an arithmetic problem or she has written something about biology. She will not clean. So most of us are either mediocre or below standard teachers. We don't rub the mind clean. When the mind is not clean, rubbed out, the same thing starts continuing in the early morning. The problem is, when it comes again early morning, it is not the first time. It is an impression that is coming again, and when the impression goes down, it has created a second impression already. Swamiji says, whenever an impression comes inside the mind and the impression comes back as a thought, know that that impression has already vibrated 20,000 times in your mind. It has vibrated so fast, it's supersonic, we don't understand. Then we want to curb the thought. The best way to curb the thought is leave the blackboard clean. But we are not able to leave it clean, we carry it. So carrying forward, and these things appear in our dream, is it not? So one of the important checks Trials are tests to see how far we are progressing in our spiritual sadhana. They say is swapna shuddhi. The dream will get purified. Unwanted, threatening, worldly dreams. Sometimes we get lots of dreams which will keep us worried. Or sometimes worries come in the dream and make us more worried. Our own worries. Otherwise, we will not be able to recognize when anything is new. And new is the most dangerous thing because it is so unknown, uncertain. And therefore, God, who is not known to us, is one of the most dangerous thing in the world. All of us are telling we want God because He is not known to us. When unknown things come to us, because we are not familiar with it, it is not within the field of our memory. God is not within the field of our memory. Our imagination about God may be in our unconscious mind, but not the real God. Thought is not God. We are all thinking about Ramakrishna is Ramakrishna, not at all. Thought about God is the distance between me and the God. When the thought collapses, then God alone is. Thought carries with it the thinker, the ego, I am. That is why Patanjali says, Yogaha Chitta Vritti Nirodaha. All the thoughts must subside. Thought is like a photograph. Photograph of my mother is not my mother. It is only a representation. Yet, they say, better to keep that, otherwise we will become wayward. We will be having so many other memories cropping up. Then they say, to keep all other memories away, keep the memory of God. So that memory has to be purified. Smriti Parishuddhi. How to do the Smriti Parishuddhi? So that the remembrance of God alone predominates. You can watch when you travel in the bus, in the train. Simply keep quiet. Don't do anything, but you will find mentally you will be doing hundreds of things, is it not? Whether you want or not, these are the mechanical actions of our own inner organ. Like you switch on, there is no thought, fan will start rotating. Most of us are mechanical. And japa also sometimes becomes mechanical. Whole spiritual practice also becomes mechanical. When it becomes mechanical, then we are caught in the unconscious stream. Consciously, when we do it with alertness, with awareness, then it is the action of the Chaitanya, attended with Shraddha. You know what you are doing with knowledge, with alertness, with awareness we are doing. God is the antithesis of unconscious, is consciousness itself. Most of the time, you repeating japa itself, you will be sleeping. It's a mechanical action. For most of us, sleeping also is a mechanical action. Is it not automatically evening we go and sleep? Because we have been doing it for long years. And as you chant the japa, start meditating, the mind becomes little quiet. And the quietness of the mind gets associated with the memory of quietness. When are you quiet throughout the day? When are you quiet? That also we are not quiet, but comparatively the external world is quiet. In the sleep also sometimes I find somebody was holding another man left and right. What happened? Well, bloody boss. Now it's 11:30, 12 o'clock. No, I was just dreaming the boss has given me something to do. It's all going on inside. We are not quiet even in the dream. The sleep we get dream. But at least the external world is shut off. Is it not? As you start sleeping, the five sense organs become quiet. Outside things are not disturbing you. Your own inner things disturb. And after some time when you start crossing the frontiers of dream world, then you sleep soundly and others are disturbed. Is it not? Last time I was coming, in the compartment everybody is snoring. Oh wow. There's a sound sleep and we can't sleep. So the quietness gets a memory link, and as soon as we start doing japam, we also go there. So that's mechanical. We are not aware or we are not alert. The memory has slipped into the unconscious channel. We came to sit and wanted to do japa, is it not? And slowly we slipped into the unconscious realm. That's how the computer, when it gets corrupted, it slips into some other thing and goes on hanging. That's all, sleeping now. Once when we were in college, we had an NCC camp. And we were highly mischievous. So mischievous that by evening 5 o'clock, in the compartment, almost all the boys were dead tired. And one of my friend, he was a Gujarati boy, was sleeping on the floor of the compartment. And by 5:30, he started snoring. He was from Santa Cruz, Santu Patel, I still remember. But when the incident happened, I never thought that it would be so helpful for me in future lectures. So as he was snoring, all other boys, we were going to Pune, Ahmednagar, they started laughing, and then immediately I thought, no, what next mischief we can do? So as we were watching, I suddenly saw a bundi. Laddu is a small piece of laddu. The bundi was there. I took the bundi. He was snoring loudly. I kept it on his lips. And these boys were watching quietly what I am doing. And within few seconds, we saw the lips shivered like this. And the lips opened, the tongue came out and took the bundi inside and ate it. And we all started laughing, ha 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 ha, like that. By that time he got up, why are you laughing? And one of the boys asked, how sweet was the bundi? Bundi, which bundi? But now you took the bundi, where? So how unconsciously the senses are acting, is it not? Look at the power of the senses. And the whole nervous system, the who is controlling us? We controlling the mind? Are the mind controlling us? That incident happened in 1974 or 75. But that incident, it left such a mark that every time I see, look and think about the mind control, it gives to me an impression how mechanically we are working, is it not? So how to break this mechanical tendency and habit of the mind? Because mechanical unconscious mind cannot catch the conscious God who is consciousness. It is very, very difficult. It is very difficult for a sleeping mind to catch God who is eternally awake. Brahman never sleeps. So the famous saying of Swamiji, teach yourselves, teach everyone his real nature. Call upon the sleeping soul and see how it awakes. Power will come, glory will come, purity will come, goodness will come. All that is excellent shall come when the sleeping soul is roused to self-conscious activity. So the spiritual sadhana, it is a self-conscious activity where we cut through the maze of desires which we have unconsciously thought over throughout our life. Most of the time you will find desires are almost arising unconsciously, is it not? You are going in a car, suddenly the board appears, taste the thunder. Long before that was the advertisement. I don't know whether you remember or not. Suddenly seeing the board, taste the thunder with Sachin Tendulkar, pouring the bottle into his mouth. Stop the vehicle, wala what? Itna garam lag raha hai, thoda sa thunder pika jayenge. That is a PepsiCola advertisement. What happened to you? You are going at 90 miles speed. That is okay. But with such a speed, the message entered inside my mind. And the man stopped the vehicle. And by that time, so many things happened. And they got late. And they told, now taste the blender. You are going for your journey. Why did you stop? So thunder, blender all combined. So in our life also these things happen. We wanted to go somewhere, then something happens and we lost the way. We wanted to do japam, we wanted to meditate, but inside thunder comes, is it not? From the unconscious, and memory interferes. There's a beautiful exercise for this, so that the unconscious well is broken. That's a long exercise. In olden days, it was called as a Brahminical way of living. But now, moment you say Brahmin, it gets colored with caste system. Originally, a Brahmin was supposed to be one who is investigating into Brahman. So, Sattva Shuddhav Dhruva Smritihi. When the Sattva elements in the mind gets purified, how to make the Sattva element purified? Sattva Shuddhav Dhruva Smriti. The memory doesn't sleep. Sleeping of the memory indicates the mechanical working of our personality. All of us are mechanical, is it not? You can sit on the chair, is it not? What is happening with the legs? Mechanical, is it not? It's not only for us. Once Buddha was taking a class, he did like this and then suddenly stopped the class. He became alert. He took that something which he threw and put it back on his thighs and then bent the thigh and again threw it back. It took nearly 4-5 minutes and Ananda, his favorite disciple, asked, "Master, why did you kill the dead mosquito?" Then Buddha told a relevant question, "The mosquito bit me and it was a reflex action. I bit it like this. It escaped my attention. I want to correct myself. No action must escape. Everything must be censored by my consciousness and my alertness. So I am correcting the old action." He took the dead mosquito, put it on the thighs. He understood that I am beating the mosquito. Mosquito is dead and I am throwing the dead mosquito. See how great leaders they work, you see. The great realized souls, Buddha, Ramana Maharshi, Vivekananda, Ramakrishna, they were so alert, nothing escapes the purview of their mind. That is how the sadhana has to be done. Otherwise, the memory itself can kidnap us anytime. So one of the sadhana they do is Smriti Parishuddhi sadhana. Why? When the sattva becomes purified, the smriti also gets stabilized. Dhruva smriti, constantly we will start getting the memory of God. The unwanted memories will be removed, the weeds will be plucked out. That is what Tulsidas says, kamadi dosha rahitam kuru manasam cha. Vishnu kama is good, but other kamas, they are all doshas. So let Vishnu kama alone remain in my heart, no, in the mind. In the heart already there is a Vishnu kama, but the kamas in the mind are interrupting me. So, hey Rama, kama adi dosha rahitam. Let the mind be free from all the other kamas, so that this kama, the desire to get Vishnu, that materializes. So in the mind, these doshas are there. Dosha rahitam kuru manasam cha. And when the mind is bereft of all other kamas and there is only Vishnu kama, akamo bhavati, a man desiring Vishnu becomes desireless, because he cannot desire Vishnu unless he gives up all other desires. At that time the mind and heart merges. Ramana also says after some time the mind merges into the heart and then the sadhana becomes non-mechanical. Then you get constant remembrance of the God, and that remembrance makes us think of God continuously. In fact, it is not remembrance at all. It is called Sahaja Sthiti. The other Sthiti is not Sahaja, it is Atma Vismrita Sthiti. We have forgotten, we are thinking of something which we should not think. And whatever we may be thinking in this world, behind all those thinking, there is I am thought present, is it not? I am thinking that. But we have forgotten the thinker and we are thinking about the objects which are thought upon. So in any thought, there is a thinker and the objects thought upon. But most of the time, we are not thinking about us, we have forgotten. So forgetting oneself, Shankara says, is suicide. Ita konvasti mudatma. Yastu swate brahmadyati durlabam manusham deha prapya tatrapi paurusham He got a human body and he has got terrific energy, power. Are a male.